So the first question is, being part of such an esteemed and successful institution, what are the key factors that keep you connected with the field?
Well, firstly, Cummins College Nagpur is supported by multinational companies like Cummins India Limited. And then we have MOUs with various other multinational companies like RPG Foundation, TCS, Persistence, and many more. So the most important thing is the networking of our college with the various industries. Secondly, we have a very good association with the national and the international professional bodies such as ISHRAE, ASM, IET, Institution of Engineers, IEEE, USA, ISA, with the student chapters at our college. Thirdly, industry persons, they come and deliver guest lectures to our students to give them the knowledge beyond syllabus. And lastly, our management has got entrepreneurs on our board. So all of them being from the industry, you know, the kind of different edge we have in the operational methodology of our sangstha and our college. Yeah, another key factor is my faculty. They bring the live problem statements from the industry with which we are connected. So the success of our institution lies in the degree of confidence that we build into our students due to their extensive and significant industry interaction. I'm happy to tell you that every year, more than 35 companies visit us for campus and pick up our students for core engineering jobs. That's why, you know, we are connected.
Wow, that's great, sir. I would like to go on to the next question and ask you that since, you know, the education domain is, you know, very evolving. So how do you keep your teachers and students acquainted with the current industry knowledge?
Okay, here the most important thing is the upgradation of the teacher's knowledge first. Because if they are having the up-to-date knowledge, then only our students will be. Okay, so we keep sending our faculty for various short-term training programs which are being conducted all throughout India. We also conduct faculty development programs every year at our college, or we send them to the various programs that are being conducted by other colleges. Some teachers also do internship at industry. You know, this gives them the total experience of industry. Then we keep our students updated through the conduct of various hands-on workshops on the latest technology-related products. These workshops are conducted in the beginning of every new semester for a period of first 1 week. These workshops are conducted partly by the industry persons and partly by our faculty who have received the required training. We encourage summer internships for our students, and let me tell you proudly that almost 100% students were engaged in the past 2 years, barring this year of pandemic situation. Okay, so
that's great. And what is the latest program offering at your institution which will help the students outperform and stand apart in the crowd?
We believe in the lifetime skill development. So at Cummins College, we are conducting skill development programs on robotics, AI, CAD, CAM, CAE to make them ready for the Industry 4.0 revolution. These courses are conducted beyond syllabus, which make our students outperform. We are also planning minor degree from the cross engineering branches to prepare our students for the multifaceted jobs. But this will take some time because we have to get some NOCs from university. Well, till that time, we keep conducting various courses and we have the required infrastructure in terms of National Instrumentation LabVIEW, campus-wide MATLAB, PTC, Creo, then the Ansys 14, programmable CNC, 3D printer, and so on. So with the help of all this infrastructure, and with the help of our Industry Connect, we keep giving our students the required knowledge for them to be ready with the Industry 4.0.
Okay, wow, sir, that's a lot of domains, by the way. Sir, what is the definition of leadership according to you?
Okay, the definition of leadership, actually, for me, you know, it is like the way I was groomed. I'm very happy to tell you that I had a chance to work under the leadership of great Dr. Abdul Kalam and then Dr. V.K. Saraswat, who is presently a member of Niti Aayog, when I was working with DRDO. And I started my career as a scientist B and went up to scientist F in just a short period of 20 years. There I learned a lot in DRDO. And the same thing now applying. I believe in one thing, that is, leadership is judged by our ability to listen. Okay? It is judged by your ability to give the right task to the right person. That is my style of working. And therefore, all the sincere and the dedicated people who are working with me are happy and satisfied to be with me.
Okay, so that's great. So moving on to the next question, how do you ensure the timely updation of curriculum based on the upcoming trends in the industry?
I'm fortunate to be a part of the Board of Studies of Electronics Telecommunication branch of RTMNU. And we had a lot of sittings in the last 1.5 to 2 years, where we had sittings with the industry also. And we have proposed many new things in the curriculum. The next batch that is going to join us would be having this new syllabus for them. The Board of Studies has blended the syllabus with the other branches. That is what we have done is we have amalgamated the things and provided large number of electives so that the cross-engineering abilities can be developed. So with this, for example, the electronics and telecommunication branch would now be actually becoming electronics and telecomputing branch. While making this syllabus, we have been consulting the industry and we have introduced a full 6 months, that is a full semester's dedicated project or the internship. For this, we are going to seek support of industry as well. And we are going to introduce the new skills and the application-oriented subjects. We are also introducing certain subjects, keeping in view that Nagpur is going to be the aerospace hub. So with that intention, you know, I have introduced some new courses such as control, guidance, and navigation, and so on. Apart from the courses like AI, ML, then Python, the advanced Java. So with this, the all our curriculum for all the three branches, that is the mechanical engineering, computer engineering, is going to be totally new, which the industry is actually looking for the students to be prepared.
Okay, so as we all know that pandemic has hit at a very uncertain time. So how has the college dealt with the delivery of the course during the pandemic?
Okay, it started all of a sudden, you know, but we were getting geared up for it for the last 2 years. The very first thing is that we had prepared our own exam portal and we had started using it, where, you know, we could conduct the exams online in the MCQ-based form. And we immediately switched over to the e-platforms for conduct of the balance syllabus when the colleges were closed down during the pandemic situation that happened on 16th of March. So all our teachers also got geared up. They prepared all the material to be given through this e-platforms. Our students adopted to various e-platforms such as Google Classroom, Zoom, and then now we are using the platform of UpGrad Live. I would like to tell you another thing which is unique for our college, that is, we are using MHRD's platform of virtual lab. For this, we trained our faculties, and now they are conducting the practicals of the students through internet. Now with this, students will be definitely getting their concepts cleared when they perform the practical on the virtual lab. And I'm very happy to tell you that we are the nodal center now of NIT Suratkal for taking this virtual labs further. And we have also got connected with many schools, and we have given them the education about this virtual labs in the recent lockdown period.
Okay, sir. So I would like to go on to the next question and ask you that how have you trained yourself and the faculty to deliver such prestigious courses to the students?
Okay, so for this, you know, always requires a plan. And during this lockdown, we sat down and discussed over the many brainstorming sessions, and we prepared a so-called SOP, that is the which would give us how to conduct the online teaching and learning. The SOP that we have prepared gives the complete methodology, how to conduct, right from how to make a video or how to make the slides, how to deliver them, how students should be reacting to it, how to take their reactions, how parents should support, what everything is covered in that SOP. And this SOP has been now employed, and we have also employed the UpGrad Live, through which, you know, all our lectures are being delivered, and they're not only getting delivered, students are able to respond through those lectures, and their attendance is getting marked. And apart from that, you know, these lectures are available as an archive. Their videos are available as an archive for the students, for them, so that if anybody has missed out because of loss of internet connectivity or whatever, they are able to see the lecture at any other time than they want. And as I mentioned previously, we also trained our faculty for the use of virtual lab. And with that, now everybody is using the virtual lab for conduct of practicals. So this is how we prepared ourselves. Apart from this, the another thing is, like, the main thing required was to prepare the attitude towards this new kind of normal. So we have to change our attitude even for the teachers. So we conducted trainings for them, like how they should be teaching, because teachers normally have the habit of asking questions to the students who are sitting in front of them. But in this particular platform, you know, you are not able to actually see the students, but you have to get their reactions. So all this change of getting it adjusted yourself to the new normals was done through some sort of trainings, then counseling of certain students was done, so that, you know, everybody comes on the same frequency and they are able to make use of this platform.
Okay, yeah. So I would like to first congratulate you, because it seems that you have taken a lot of efforts to make the new normal. So I would like to move on to the next question and ask you that what are the kinds of projects which students do during their internship or maybe at the college?
Well, the unique thing for our college is that our students do the projects right from their first year. I don't think this kind of thing is there in any other college. And here, you know, we give them something called as a micro project or a conceptual understanding project. And in the second year and third year, they do the mini project also. Because there is one thing which I believe in, is that students learn better or more when they do the projects. Because when you execute a project, you have to plan, you have to learn, you have to execute. So these three things, they get to know about this because of the projects. And that is how the final year project, when they come to the final year, they are already geared up. And let me tell you, the kind of SOP or the USP we have at Cummins College is that the projects are allotted in the sixth semester itself. And where the students complete their literature survey in the sixth semester, and in the seventh semester, they start off with their project right from the day one. And the projects are regularly reviewed personally by me, because I sit in their reviews. And every review, they are told what is expected from them, what is it that they should be presenting. And stage by stage review is done to see to it that all the projects are built in the college. So this is the beauty of our college, that we build the projects in the premises itself. Neither they are purchased nor they are bought out by anybody from outside. So with this, you know, my students, they speak out very confidently when they go for the campus interviews. That is the advantage they have. Thank you.
That's great. And so I, as a, you know, esteemed dignitary of such a prestigious college, I would like to ask you that what are the benefits and career options by choosing this field as a career, engineering?
Well, the most important benefit to our students is that when they pass out from Cummins College, they are equipped with the life skills and a full confidence to face the outside world. This is the most important thing. Many students, they get either placed in the core engineering companies or IT companies, and IT companies are also the core engineering for the computer engineering students. Some students, they opt for the higher education, so they go for either MEM Tech or some additional course of another skill development. And few take up the entrepreneurship also. So whatever they choose, they are well equipped for their life skills. That is the most important benefit and the future career options for them.
Okay, sir. So, so the last question for the day. So as a principal of such a esteemed college, what is your suggestion to the youth of today?
Okay, as a principal, I would like to say that our expectation is that students should develop an aptitude and attitude towards e-learning, because now that is a new normal. Well, the classes would start and again they would be able to come to the college. But still, you know, it is going to be more of e-learning, because there is now a lot of e-content available. So they should make use of this e-content. And I would also like to tell you that we are the only college where we have the licenses for Coursera, which we have given to our students. And our students have registered for more than 250 courses for these online MOOCs, which are available through Coursera, and they're doing those courses. So today's youth should put more time and efforts to acquire some additional skills. That is what I would like to say as a principal. And one special thing which I would like to tell to those who are aspiring to do engineering, just have faith in us, join Cummins with their first preference, and we assure your metamorphosis, that is your four-year transform, into a very confident lady who will not be only professionally sound, but also be ready to take up the challenges of life ahead. Thank you.
Okay, so I think we've done here for the interview. I would like to thank you for giving your time to us. And definitely, I will make sure that your message reaches all the young women who are aspiring to become engineers. Thank you.
Thank you.